easy start out by doing what I have been oriented to do in this recent appointment by acknowledging our friends who have come to join us this morning, as well as all of you who have taken the time to come to this gathering. If I may just acknowledge the presence of our Honorable Chief Minister from Guam, Honorable Ahmad Rahim. I'd like to also acknowledge the presence of our Congressman, the Congressman from Cagayan de Oro, Congressman Lucas Rodriguez. Under Secretary Lord William Rera, and the vote is already here. I understand Congressman Major Mother will be coming as well. Provincial Governor of the United Islands, Honorable Dilo Dahari, which is already here. Our Treasurer of the Subao, Nainan Sabong, Magsaka, Inc., Jasmine Toriano. Our former National Council President, Society of Filipino Foresters, Forester Tony Valdez. Father Joel Tabora, good morning, Father. Very well and good friend. Thank you for coming, Father Joel. Our Archbishop Antonio Ledesma, who is also here. Archbishop, and of course, Reverend Plaza, who was here earlier, I saw him. And all our partners from the private sector, our speakers who agreed to join us today, our DNR family and our friends in the media, good morning. I'd like to begin my message today by sharing a statement with the President during his sauna last year. There is no question that the preservation of the environment is the preservation of life. If we cannot mitigate climate change, all our plans for the economy, all our plans for the future will be for naught. This administration's agenda, particularly of the creation of green jobs by pursuing a green and blue economy and establishing livable and sustainable communities, has guided the DNR now in achieving better pathways and more responsive pathways in order to fulfill our mandate to conserve, protect, manage, restore, and regenerate our country's environment and hopefully our natural resource systems as well. We also aim to manage risk and build resilience using a rich relief approach to ensure that no communities are left behind. Today's DNR Multi-Stakeholder Forum in Mindanao is an opportunity for all of us to gather both evidence and expertise to support the administration's priorities for economic recovery and climate resilient and inclusive development, as well as a just transition towards a clean and blue economy. We at the DNR firmly believe that addressing issues pertaining to the environment and our country's natural resources needs a comprehensive risk approach and multi-stakeholder partnerships for evidence-informed, inclusive, and adaptive leadership in this sector. We need continued dialogue in search for common ground to bolster cooperation through understanding so that we can overcome the challenges of coherence and implementation. As you may know, the DNR began moving these multi-stakeholder consultations because partnerships, we believe, are key to delivering on our commitments to service and the work that we do at the department. There is no perfect approach or solution, in fact, to tackling the environmental challenges we face. However, with everyone's support and collaboration together, we will be able to craft and lead adaptive, inclusive, and sustainable development pathways, build at least strategic partnerships and sound science. While we continue to expand the partnerships, we also strive to deepen our engagement with all the DNR stakeholders across different sectors. We recognize as well the critical role of local government that local governments play in building resilient communities and the efficient use, conservation, and protection of our natural resources.